We're going to talk about a degenerative spondylolisthesis. You might have looked at the section on an ischemic spondylolisthesis, and that has to do with the break in a bone. In this section, the term degenerative means wearing out, and that's exactly what happens. In this particular problem, we have a disc that becomes worn, putting more wear on the joints and back here, and these joints eventually become worn. When they become worn, it allows the vertebra to slide forward. You can see in a normal and intact vertebra, the vertebra can slide backward, but cannot slide forward because these joints or doorstops in back are intact. This is a model that I've created so you can understand what the doorstop looks like. Again, we can see this vertebra here hooks into the back of the vertebra below, this black structure I call the doorstop. And what this structure does is it prevents the vertebra from sliding forward. You can see the vertebra can slide backward. There is no bony block to prevent that, but it won't slide forward. But on the level below here, if you look at it, you'll see that these points or these doorstops are worn. And if you press forward on them, this whole spine will now shift forward, and that has significant implications for the spinal canal. We're now talking about the degenerative spondylolisthesis and what the importance is of one vertebra sliding forward on another. If you think of the spinal canal as concentric rings of bone piled perfectly one on top of another, and then you slide one ring on the other, you can see how the spinal canal narrows, and that narrowing is a condition called stenosis. The importance of the spinal canal is that it changes in volume with different spinal positions. Again, this is the back of the spine, and this is the front. Your face would be facing in this direction. The spinal canal, when you bend forward, actually enlarges by 20 to 30%. And when you bend backward, the spinal canal narrows by 20 to 30%. So if you already have a problem inside the spinal canal where there is narrowing and you essentially stand up, you narrow the canal more and you develop symptoms in your back, buttocks, and legs. And finally, if the symptoms become overwhelming, you then bend forward, either leaning on a shopping cart, sitting down, or maybe bending and leaning over a counter. This will open up the spinal canal and give you relief of your symptoms.